The sun does not have no prisoners. Oh shit!
And there it is. It took me a while, but I found it. For some reason, I couldn't find it on Ray William Johnson's video, or I couldn't find it on my history. I don't know if it's taken down, or maybe didn't get permission on one of the videos in it. Maybe it was that video. I don't know. Maybe I didn't look hard enough, but yeah, I found it. I found it on the original vlogger's page, which the name is Grady1331. Never heard of him. He's from Texas. It's amazing, all those Texas vloggers, and half of them I didn't even know. But yeah, let's listen to that again here. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, hopefully. What can Brown do for you? what's interesting about that, I actually looked up, he has a follow-up vlog, and apparently that UPS truck wasn't supposed to be on that street, because there's a no trucks allowed sign off the freeway. Now I wonder where he is in Texas, because it kind of looks familiar. It's funny. Texas is funny, because all of their designs on their overpasses are exactly the same, obviously. I just thought about that. I guess that would be all the same. But, you know, if it's in Texas and they don't tell you it's in Texas, all I got to do is look at the overpasses, because it's always going to have this, like, brick. And then sometimes, not all the times, they have a little Texas symbol in the brick on the overpass. And it's a dark, or it's not a dark, it's a it's going to be like a reddish brick style. Yeah, it's going to be like red, I guess. I actually tried to do a show earlier today, but it didn't work out. I had absolutely no content. And I'm actually drinking right now, so it takes the edge off. Not necessarily the edge. I'm not real, you know, I'm not nervous about this at all. I have, like, no nerves at all. It's just, you know, it's just really hard to be funny all the time. You know, it's hit and miss. I saw a story online today, earlier this morning. Let's see if I can bring it up. I don't know if I can. God. Whoa. Oh, there it is. Yeah, there's a German diver. Is that what you call him? In the Olympics, a diver. Is he called a diver? I don't know. Springboard diving. Well, it's a German diver by the name of Stephen Feck. Feck. And yeah, he it was an epic fail. And I'm curious to see why exactly he did that. I mean, basically he went off the board, and his form off the board was fine, but once he got into the air, I mean, they did a close up. Oh, they did a close up on his face, and he just looked like he just didn't want to. He looked nervous. I mean, he was just like, "This is my moment, and I'm gonna screw it up." I mean, he was... It's like he was determined to screw it up or something. I don't know. But basically, he went in... Oh, God. He went into the... He basically jumped. The form basically lost it as soon as he got into the air. And he basically landed on his back. He did a belly flop on his back, basically. Back flop, I guess it would be called, not really a belly flop. But, it's funny. Check it out on YouTube, or not on YouTube. It may be on YouTube. Yeah, but his name is Stephen Feck, F-E-C-K, as opposed to the other word. Hey, it's raining right now. I don't know if you can hear the thunder. Probably not, because this epic microphone. The blue ball microphone. It'd be nice if they could sponsor my show. Probably needed some viewers before that. But yeah, I mean, the dude that crashed an UPS truck, he's fine. Bike is fine. I gotta get my show notes here. Hold on a second. Jerry Jones glory hole. Did I talk about that on the last show? I don't think I did. Cause you know, I'm really not sure on how I'm going to do the audio in here, and I'm assuming I can hear it, or you could hear it, if I just play the audio through the computer. But the whole thing is with this broadcast thing. See, look, watch this. See, you can see that obviously, and. And I was actually using a double monitor, a dual monitor, and it was nice, but it was bogging down a lot of my video memory, and it was creating a lot of lag on the gaming end. And there's, as you can see, my player isn't as laggy as it was before. That's the reason why, because I had it on a dual monitor, and it was, the video memory was getting a real bogged down, and it was just lagging out. So, but, I'm trying to make a soundboard also, and I can't figure out how I'm gonna do that. You know, I may just, it sounds really tacky, but I may just, use my tablet over here as a soundboard and just pull, just hold it up to the mic, which it's just, it just sounds real tacky. And I'm trying to figure out a way I could do that. And I know with Windows 7 you can like split, you can like drag screens and they'll like line up, you know, but I've only done that once and I have no idea how to do that. So, but you know, as you can see, I can't really move Windows cuz it'll show in there. That's basically my board for my Ustream thing that I broadcast through. It's basically my power. I mean, I can do the intro music. I can change screens. I can create new screens and everything. It's actually a pretty cool client. It's actually free too. So, and I like free stuff because my budget's like zero right now. Actually, I'm in the negative. I'm just gonna say that for my radio show budget, I'm in the negative, obviously, because I haven't made any money yet. That's obvious, and I still have zero viewers on my Ustream side. So, you know, I understand why. I mean, during the beginning here, I don't plan on having a lot of. It's gonna be consistent, but it's not gonna be consistent on the same day. So, you know, I may do a vlog on a Monday, or I may do a vlog on a Friday, or a vlog. What the hell? A radio show. I may do a radio show on a Monday, or I may do a radio show on a Friday. It all just depends on my schedule for work. And yeah, I mean, that and my schedule will be changing because, you know, I like where I'm working now, but I am an EMT, and that's what I do, that's what I am, that's what I want to do, and I don't want to sell TVs. I like selling TVs, but I don't want to sell TVs. It's a lot easier to sell somebody life than it is a TV. It's like, hey, do you want me to save you today? What can I get for you, or what can I do for you to save your life? You know, that's different than say, how would you like this TV? Would you like to hear about the features of this TV? You know, that's just, I am not a salesman. I can't sell. I mean, that is just not who I am. I'm not a car salesman. I can't go up to somebody and say, hey, I can get you 0% financing for 36 months. How would you like to apply for a credit card today? We have this TV right here and this one that's better than this one. The contrast ratio is 6 million to 1 on this one. It's like, it's just not there. I mean, you know, and when I got hired, I go, hey, I know a lot about gaming. And he's like, okay, you're in home theater. And I know, I have consistently sold. I mean, I think I was at like $15,000 last month. My personal sales were $15,000. Which sounds high, but they want us at about $48,000 a month on sales. And they want us to do at least 30% of that with the credit card and to sell the credit card. And see, I mean, I think I could, the problem with me is if I don't believe in something, if I don't touch it, if I don't use it, I can't sell it. Like I could sell the shit out of this blue ball microphone that I'm using right now, because I'm using it, I'm touching it. You know, I could sell it because I know it, I've been using it. I could sell this TV I'm looking at right now because I know it. I could sell Second Life, which is the program you're watching right now. But if, you know, those Samsung TVs we have are really, really nice, and I like them. But do I use one every? I do use one every day now, because, or not every day, but most days. But I it's just not in me. I don't have that smoothness as a salesman. You know, I can't transition from one thing to the next very well. It's just not me. I'm not. Don't do something that you don't actually believe in, because you're never gonna succeed at it. I mean, could I succeed and be a manager at Best Buy? Jesus, yes, I could. Do I want to? Hell no. You know, I'm not a manager. I'm not manager type. I'm not that type A personality that wants and has to control every aspect of everything. I'm just not that person. I can lead, but I'm not managing material. I can't do the scheduling. I can, but I don't like it. I hate it. But yeah, I mean, I'm waiting to get back into an ambulance, which is going to be soon. I'm going to try to so either this month or next month, because I am they're actually paying for a trip for us to go to Denver for for like a conference thing. They're paying for all the employees to do that. And I've been wanting to go to Denver for a while now, and I might as well get a free trip to Denver. I mean, shit. Why not? So I'm probably going to be getting back into an ambulance next month. The company that I'm talking to, their operations manager was on sick leave for a while, so they kind of had a hiring freeze. I would basically just been waiting for that. I mean, just waiting for him to come back and. Where I belong, son, that and talking on the microphone. But anyway, so Sleeping Dogs is coming out on the 14th. I thought it was coming out on the 12th, so I was thinking next week I have an almost identical schedule to this week, except I work on, or this week I worked on Monday, next week I don't work until Friday, Thursday, so I get 3 days off. And I was going to grab the PVR on Saturday, and then PVR some footage from Sleeping Dogs, and then put it up probably Monday when I was trying to do Monday, but, you know, I've never used a PVR before. The game doesn't come out until the 14th, so I can't do it on Monday. So what I'm probably going to do is start putting up Battlefield videos on whenever I get the PVR. You know, it may take me a while to figure out the whole PVR thing. You know, so hopefully, I've never used the PVR before. And the nice thing is my discount has finally kicked in, so that's pretty freaking epic. I know for a fact that the PVR that we have is it's $250, and my discount brings it down to about $135. So that's pretty nice. And it's funny because the PVR is basically the last set of equipment that I planned on buying for this whole radio YouTube thing. So basically, I mean, after that, I don't need Best Buy anymore. I mean, I'm not gonna buy computer parts at Best Buy because I get that off Newegg, and even with my discount, Newegg beats my discount I get at Best Buy. So, and Best Buy really doesn't have all the parts I want anyway. So. And I'm probably gonna get a new graphics card again. I really like the graphics card I have now. But this computer that I'm building isn't not a medium gaming computer. It's gonna be like it's gonna be something that's gonna last me for, you know, at least 7 years. If I can get it to last me 7 years, I'll be happy. With the technology as fast as it goes. Well, my current build has lasted me for five years. Oh. 28, and I have voice pitches.
There's also a game coming out called Watch Dogs. It's basically a free world technological assassin game, I guess would be kind of like the description of it. Check it out on YouTube. It looks like it's going to be pretty epic. It's made by Ubisoft Montreal, which is the same company that makes Assassin's Creed and Far Cry, I believe. Never played Far Cry. So I really couldn't tell you much about Far Cry, but It looks pretty awesome. The graphics on it look pretty awesome. And so something I can't figure out about gamers is that they're like bashing on the PS3, like you can't get any better graphics than what you're getting. FYI, if I get kicked off, it's because it's lightning outside. The house just had an electrical spike. So if I, like, all of a sudden go away, that's why I went away, because it's actually raining outside right now, which surprises the hell out of me. It hasn't rained here for a long time. Like, heavily rained for a long time. Which is nice, because we needed it here in Oklahoma City. Nothing like a good rainstorm. But yeah, I mean, Battlefield has some nice expansion packs coming out here. Let's check. Dun dun dun. Oh yeah, I mean, it's been. Yeah, speaking of the weather. So I keep hearing over and over again that this year is the hottest year that we've had on record. It's hot out. I'm not gonna lie to you. It's hot, but is it hot? I mean, last year sucked.
What the heck?
It's hot out,
but I don't think it's as hot as it was last year.
Or no, I take that back. It's as hot as it was last year, but it's not consistently as hot as it was last year.
Hold on a second. I just gotta. I'm trying to bring out my battle log here.
And, you know, I do apologize if my content is a little bit scattered. You know, I'm trying to find a good, obviously I have no viewership. So, you know, I'm just trying to basically fish around a little bit and see where something sticks. You know, if I can do a little bit of gaming, a little bit of news, and I mean, I'm not going to do entertainment unless it involves something that I like. I'm not going to talk about Lady Gaga or what's her face? I can't think of her name right now. I'm not going to talk about the foo-foo-y entertainment stuff. That ain't happening. What I do want to do is do like parodies of like real life stuff, like, you know, not necessarily bad events, but, you know, try to make something funny that's in the news. So, you know, like voiceovers or something. I do want to be doing something like that. I just gotta find my premium here real fast. Okay, pulling up my premium calendar. Wait a minute. Today's the 7th. According to the Battlefield Battle Log calendar, it's August. According to the Battle Log calendar, we should have some new content coming out today. Because today is the 7th, isn't it? Yes. Whoops. And it says we have new camos. Which, the whole... If you play Battlefield and you're a premium member, the whole camouflage thing. I mean, I like it. I like wearing new camos, but the whole idea of putting them in assignments, I understand what they're doing, because they're giving you a reason to keep playing the game.
But yeah, we got new. New camos today. I played Battlefield today, and there was no new camo on there.
I'll have to check that out. I mean, I'm assuming what they're doing with the camo is that they
had it in the original pack that you downloaded, and basically they just unlock it on the day.
I'll have to check that out. Too bad I can't
PVR it. I love Battlefield, though. That's such a great game. Such a great game. It's too bad it's made by EA Sports, because EA Games. I mean, I despise EA Sports.
I mean, they put such a bad taste in my mouth with the NCAA 09 that I just, like,
you know what? What's going on here? Well, why is he asking me to be his friend? That's weird. I had a guy friend request me that I haven't played with for like 6 months. That's weird. It's all right. I'll be your friend, man. Just kind of strange that you're like, hey, remember me? I want to be your friend too. But yeah, okay. Here's my my Battlefield stats. I have 426 hours and 5 minutes on Battlefield. I have 15 service stars as a medic, 4 service stars as an engineer, 3 stars as support, and 2 stars as a sniper or a recon class. Cuz sniper is a bad definition for this game, because camping in Battlefield just isn't, it's just not a good idea, because
I mean, if I'm playing the game and you're camping, I will find you and I will knife you. I love knifing people, and every second that I get a chance to knife you, I will knife you. I mean, it's just an epic animation when you knife somebody. It's just, there's just so much satisfaction in it that I find every chance that I get and I use it.
Like, I mean, basically what I do is I'll you know, if I see somebody camping, you know, I'll basically go completely behind the map, you know, go completely out of the way and come up behind you. And what most people don't understand with Battlefield is your MAV, the MAV. Is that the right termination for it? Yeah, it's a little robot you can, like, fly around and spot people. Well, that also destroys spawn beacons, and it also destroys it'll destroy spawn beacons, other MAVs, and the little sensor things. I can't think of the name of them are right now. And basically, I'll just start flying that thing around, and I'll destroy their little sensor thing so they can't see me coming up. And 90% of the time, they're not paying attention anyway. So I'll just run up behind them and knife them. And I just love the really crappy recon guys that'll just continually sit there and camp in the same spot, and I'll just continually come up and knife them. I mean, it pisses them off. I've had several people like send me an instant message on PlayStation and say, "You're a freaking loser. What do you keep knifing me for? You're a faggot," and all that stuff. And
hey, don't camp.
Don't camp. We won't have this problem, will we? I mean, come on. It's not rocket science. You know, and there's plenty of weapons not to use as a recon guy, not camp. The M417, which would be it's not an M417 in real life. Is that the HK417 or something like that? God, that is such an epic rifle.
It's not
full auto, but it's semi-automatic, and that thing is just a beast. If you're in the right game with the right players, you can dominate with that gun. I mean, I've gone like 52-12 on several matches with that gun. And that's better than most of my fully automatic recon or medic games that I've played. You know, I'm weird with Battlefield because I'm not consistent in any area. Or not, I'm consistent as a medic, but I'm not consistently good with my kill death ratio. I mean, some games I'll go 50-12 or 50-20 or a positive number like that. And some games I'll go like 52-48 or 52-51 or even 52-60. You know, I'm not. You know, that's all that has to do with a lot of the team aspect of it too. Oh, I mean, if you don't have a good team, you're not going to win at that game. Battlefield is all about the teamwork. God, I love Myers Rum. And it's something, you know, what I do like about Battlefield is they have your battle log where you can basically, I mean, it's the battle log is kind of like Facebook, but with Battlefield, you can leave a status message like, hey, I'm shitting right now, or something that I'm consistently notorious for. Well, you know, I have no status, so, you know, I might as well be putting something in there. And basically, I mean, you can look at your weapon assignments, your vehicles, your awards. Like right now, I've got quite a few medical medals. Which one is it? Is it this one? I've got a U.S. Marine Service Medal for... Wait a minute. How's that like? It says you have to have 100 hours, but I have 91 hours, and it's giving me the medal already. That's weird. Where's my... I've got 10 Savior medals. Oh, here it is, right here. I've got 15 medical medals, which basically, I mean, you have to get certain amount of ribbons to get the medals. So I've got 700. God dang. I've got 757 medical efficiency ribbons, and I think for every 10, I may be wrong, that may be 50. It's either for every 10 or 50 ribbons you get a medal. So since I've got 15 medical or 15 medical medals. Oh yeah, here we go. You have to obtain the medical ribbon 50 times in order to get a medical medal. So I've got 15 medical medals, and I've got 757 medical ribbons. What's a high number here? What's this one right here? Ooh, Jesus. I've got 1,118 conquest ribbons, which basically, you know, has something to do with conquest. I don't know what exactly you do with that. I mean, I consistently play as a medic. I mean, I am kind of going to different areas right now, but I mean, I just like playing as a medic because obviously it's kind of what I am in real life. Besides my epic radio program. do, do, do. And my current rank, I'm at a Colonel Service Star 35. Which I think I should be better than that. I mean, my kill death ratio is not great. Well, I'm sorry, my win loss ratio. Actually, my win loss ratio is at a negative right now. So it's basically I'm losing more than I'm winning. But you know, like I said, that has to do with the team more than anything. If you get a good squad and a good team, that could be a positive number. But obviously, I don't play with. Well, I do got several friends I do play with, but it's not on a consistent basis. I'm gonna just check what else here I got. Still here. Oh, okay. This is pretty epic, actually. So yesterday I had a customer and it came in the store and there's a bunch of fires in Oklahoma right now because of the drought, and this guy's house caught on fire and he lost everything, which sucks. It sucks, but he double insured his house. So he's getting $15,000 for every room in his house. So that's pretty epic. That's sad to lose your house, but I mean I'm just thinking what I could do with $15,000 for each room. I mean, just think about it for a second. For your living room, you could probably get, you could get the sharp 80-inch TV that's 3D capable and a smart TV, plus maybe a living room set. Or I mean, you could do the same thing with the new Samsung has a 90-inch coming out. That's, I think it's gonna come around $10,000. You can get that. But I just think that's just crazy. I mean, double insure your house and you'll be taken care of. Let's see what else I can talk about here. There's Mr. Feck again. Yeah, I don't really want to talk about anything political. I mean, I do want to talk about political stuff, but I'm an equal opportunity radio show. I want my viewers to be liberal. I want my viewers to be conservative. I want my viewers to be independent. I don't want to alienate one side or the other. You know, I am a conservative. I'm 100% conservative. I'm just going to tell you that. You know, I did consistently listen to Glenn Beck. I don't anymore because I just don't have time. I do go over to theblaze.com to read up on news. I don't watch CNBC or MSNBC. If I do watch news, I prefer Fox. That's because, I mean, it just seems like those other TV stations are just so obviously objective oriented, and I just don't like having socialism driven down my mouth the whole throat on a consistent basis. I mean, I fundamentally disagree with the entire idea of socialism. Every aspect of it, I disagree with. And if somebody comes up to me and tries to explain it to me, I don't care. I don't care. I fundamentally disagree with it. And history also fundamentally disagrees. What is this? That's weird. I mean, just look back in history and see how socialism has failed. Because, you know, socialism does lead into communism, and communism is a fundamentally flawed system. And that's all I'm going to say. I'm not Rush Limbaugh, so I'm not going to sit here and ram this. I'm not going to ram my beliefs down your throat. I'm just not that kind of a person. I mean, if you want to believe in that, that's all right with me. I'm not for one group or the other. I want everybody to succeed in whatever they want to do. If you want to start an organization for communism and try to get communism in the United States Senate, that's all right with me. Go ahead and try to do it. At the end of the day, the voter speaks what they want. I don't. So if you fundamentally believe in something, go do it. Don't hold back. I mean, that's one of the problems with society today, is people are so reluctant to speak for what they believe because of what they think other people what other people are going to think. And it's just, here's a good example. Like, you know, when our current president was being elected, everybody was like, well, he's not a socialist, and all that stuff. 2 years later, or not even that, Time Magazine or something, is socialism, you know, this is the new socialism. I mean, why lie about it? Just tell us who you really are. Just don't fake it. Just, I respect our current president. And I respect him, but I don't believe in what he believes in. And I don't think it's right to lie to people in order to obtain something. Because eventually it's going to catch up to you. And that's not good. It's just not good. I mean, it's better to be elected based on truth than it is to be elected on lies. And that goes for everything. That's not being elected. I mean, it's better just to be truthful about stuff than it is to be dishonest. Because eventually it's going to catch up to you. I mean, it's inevitable. Sitting a little bit far away from the mic, so it may sound a little silent. But like I said in my last vlog, I'm actually sitting on the floor right now. I have no desk, so I'm kind of starting from scratch. So basically, here's what's going down with the radio show. Like I said, it's not gonna be consistently on the same day for now. And I am gonna be. Did I say that already? No, I don't think I did. If I did, I'll say it. For my videos, I realize my videos are gonna be longer than what most people are comfortable watching. And, you know, viewership on YouTube, about a 10-minute video is going to be one to be your max, because people don't want that much time taken away just watching a video. And I understand that. I do that myself. The only videos that I watch that are only over 10 minutes are the Shaytards. Um, So I don't expect you to watch my entire video. If you do, thank you. It's gonna be rough here at the beginning. It's gonna be really rough because I gotta figure out how to get into this groove of getting content for the show. What kind of skits I'm gonna be doing, as far as like, you know, what I said. It's gonna be rough. You know, there's some shows are gonna suck. I'm not gonna lie to you. This show really sucks because I really don't have that much content. You know, I have to start drinking alcohol in order to get through an entire show without shutting it off. And it's my own video. But, you know, it's gonna get better. I just gotta get through all the bugs, and I have to get into a groove of getting content, finding content, talking about content, what content I'm gonna be talking about, gaming, life in general, whatever. And eventually I do want to get some other people in on the show. I'm not quite sure how that's gonna happen. That's gonna be a while. You know, I don't plan on making any money for a while. Probably a couple years, probably. Maybe a year. I do enjoy it, I gotta say. I mean, I do enjoy sitting down and talking into a big black ball. And you know, this channel is also going to consist of other stuff, and I also motovlog. If people who watched my video have never heard of a motovlog, check out my other YouTube channel at The Medic J. Oh, and speaking of channels and Twitters and Facebooks and all that crap, I do have a Facebook page. I was about to say channel. I do have a Facebook page. It's J Palmer. Just like my show. It's not J Palmer Live, it's just J Palmer. So you can friend me, like me. I don't think you can like me right now. You can just friend me. I'm not that big yet. I'm not gonna be making a Twitter page based on, you know, I'm not gonna make a J Palmer Twitter or J Palmer Live Twitter. Just go to my Twitter at The Medic J. Twitter, The Medic J. I think that's right. Yeah, I mean, I have like several Twitters. Twitterers. I'm a Twitter whore. I started out with Jay the chauffeur, and then I went over. That was a fun job, by the way. I like playing the sirens better though. So yeah, it's The Medic J at YouTube and Twitter. I also have Google Plus. No, let's just keep that out for now. I'm actually gonna make another Google Plus for my live channel, because the nice thing about YouTube is it's through Google. Google is Google Plus, so basically once you start a YouTube channel, you're pretty much in for Google Plus. And YouTube and Gmail. I think so. Yeah, I mean, basically what I'll do on the description section of this video, you're probably watching this on YouTube. You know, I'm also gonna I'll put that all in the description section. I'm also wanting to shit. I just second. I'm you know, I would also like to do live. God dang it. Sorry about that. Live social feeds. So you know, I want my viewers to be involved with the program. You know, if it, you know, it'd be nice if I could have content streaming with viewers saying, "Hey, look at this. We could talk about it together." This isn't just about me talking into a black microphone. It's about the viewers, even though I have none right now. So yeah, I mean, this isn't just about me and my content and what I want to do. It's all about what the viewers want to do. And like I said, I'll be changing my radio station, my radio show, based on what kind of viewers I get. You know, if I get a bunch of transgender people want me to talk about mascara, I'm not doing it. Sorry, that's just not what I am or who I am. I have nothing against the transgender community. I've seen some fairly attractive transgenders, but I'm not going to talk about mascara. I'm just not that kind of person. And no, I am not into transgenders. Pre-op. Yeah. No. I'm just going to shut up. Wow, that was creepy. And yeah, I mean, see, I still got to activate my DirecTV. Because I do want to be I do want to talk about Ghost Adventures. I love that show. Like, I love that show, like, totally. I would talk about 24, but it's not on anymore. And they should be making a movie. It should have been out by now, actually. Come to think about it. What was that, 2 years ago? Yeah. It should be out soon. If not, that's all right. I got stuff that I could watch, I guess. God, that's good room. Shoo. It's completely satisfying. Is it creepy when I whisper into the mic? Do you want to rub onto my nipples? You want to see my nipples? You want to see my nipples, don't you? Oh my god. We can rub our nipples together and sing songs. But anyway, now for the creepy whisper man. So yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say today. Like I said, you know, I actually may do another radio program sometime this week. It may be tomorrow or Thursday. Tomorrow or Thursday. So, but I have to get a bunch of content. You know, I'm trying to figure that out. Do I want to do one show a week or a couple shows a week? It's probably going to be one show a week for now, because I really don't have a whole lot of time. I mean, it's really hard to get content to last more than 30 minutes, and I have to grab a lot of content. It's the type of stuff that, you know, you're basically not even thinking about it at the time. You go, you pass something and say, hey, that could be radio content. You know, it's just, it's really, really hard to get enough content for an entire show. I'm definitely going to have to get another glass of that. So satisfying. Just like butter. It's like butter on toast. It's smooth and refreshing. That makes absolutely no sense. And you know, this whole thing is going to be easier with multiple people. Multiple people. That's creepy. So yeah, I'm going to attempt to do the outro music here, so... But before I do the outro music, I need to thank Kevin MacLeod for my royalty-free intro and outro music. I'm also going to put a link in that on YouTube so I don't get banned from YouTube because of music. So, Kevin MacLeod, it's incompetech, I think, .com. Let me go check just to make sure here. Oh, that's super fantastic. I already... Da, da, da. Da. Whoops, I gotta go back. See, this is smooth. This is smooth radio-ness. Yeah, that... I think it's a Compotech.com. You'll see it in the, it's like free, it's like royalty-free music something.com or in Compotech. Same company. Kevin MacLeod. Good dude. Free royalty-free music. Good royalty-free music. Probably going to be using a lot of it here since I have no budget. So, yeah, that's about it. So, let's try my royalty music, and I will see you guys later.